I've never bought or sold any cryptocurrencies. Obviously, I wish I had, Michelle. I mean, what's crypto? Bitcoin's worth $60,000 or something today. I wish I'd bought some of it. Wish I'd bought anything. Wish I'd bought IBM in 1914, et cetera, et cetera. I doubt it because historically, if Bitcoin or cryptocurrencies become successful, most governments will outlaw it because they don't want to lose their monopoly. Every government in the world is working on computer money now, including the US. The Chinese are there already. And I cannot imagine that governments are going to say, okay, this is our crypto money, or you can use their crypto money. That's not the way governments work historically. Money is going to be on the computer. It already is in China. In China, you can't take a taxi with money. You got to have the money on your phone. You can't buy ice cream. So it's happening, but I doubt if it's going to be somebody else's money. History shows it will be government
So
money they like.
you would argue then that the biggest threat to Bitcoin, which is now at over $63,000, is government regulation or government intervention?
Yes, if it becomes successful, Michelle, as long as it's a trading vehicle, and I know guys are making lots of money trading it, it's a wonderful trading vehicle, apparently. But if it becomes a currency, which is what the crypto people say they are, and they will be, I cannot imagine that any government or many governments in the world will say, okay, you can use our money or their money. That's not what history shows.
All right, well, we do have, of course, central banks starting to pay attention to cryptocurrencies and Bitcoin and digital currencies around the world, to your point. And Powell is actually putting Bitcoin and gold in the same camp. Let's take a listen to what he had to say about that.
We think of them more as crypto assets because crypto, what people call cryptocurrencies, they're really vehicles for speculation. No one is using them for payments, for example, like the dollar. What they're using them for is to speculate. It's a little bit like gold. For thousands of years, human beings have given gold this special value that it doesn't have from an industrial standpoint. But nonetheless, for thousands of years, they've done that. So Bitcoin is much more like that, and the cryptocurrencies are much more like that. They're not really being actively used as payments.
Do you agree with that? Is it like gold?
Well, it's
Or is
certainly
that just an
something.
offense to your sensibilities to put Bitcoin and gold in the same camp?
No, of course not. Anything that the world wants to use is fine with me. But he said the same thing I do. The people are using it as trading vehicles, which is exactly what it is so far. If it becomes a currency, then something else will change. No, there's no question that what he said about it, it's like, I mean, you cannot go down to the shop and buy bread with gold right now. You cannot go down to the shop and buy bread with Bitcoin either right now. But history would indicate that silver and gold probably have a better future because they're not trying to compete with the dollar or the yen or something else, something like that.
Well, you can increasingly use your Bitcoin to buy Teslas and more and more assets as it's becoming more mainstream to use that as a form of payment and to receive it as a salary as well. But Jim, I want to focus on inflation because, of course, with this unprecedented stimulus, there are a lot of concerns about inflation. Former Treasury Secretary Larry Summers is one of many sounding the alarm over inflation and the overheating economy. Now, Summers is actually saying that the country has embarked on the least responsible macroeconomic policies that the US has had in the last 40 years. How concerned are you about inflation, and how do you position yourself accordingly?
Well, I know that always in the past, if you print staggering amounts of money and borrow staggering amounts of money, it leads to inflation. It always has. I don't see any reason that it won't this time. I can already see that inflation is happening. Go down to the shop, Michelle. Education, insurance, just about everything. Entertainment, just about everything. Prices are going up a whole lot. Governments lie about inflation and they have incentive to lie about it, so they do. No, look out the window. There's inflation, whether we like it or not, and it seems to be getting worse.
So, what is your advice? What is the best way to protect against this inflation or to position oneself to benefit from it?
Well, my way is to buy commodity indexes because by definition, if cotton goes up, if copper goes up, that's inflation. And if you own the commodity indexes, you are participating. You're part of it.
When you say commodity indices and focusing particularly on gold and silver, does that mean that you advocate for buying gold and silver ETFs or just physical gold and silver?
Well, I have some of both, but there's some commodity indexes that I came up with. They're listed on the New York Stock Exchange. One is RJA, which is the Rogers Agricultural Index. It's a basket of 20 or so commodities. That's what I meant by. I'm talking about real commodities. You can also buy the metals indexes, the agricultural indexes, the energy indexes. That's my way of play because, as I say, if the price of oil goes up, I own oil, natural gas, etc.
Well, right. So, Jim, much of the concern is like we have all of these fundamentals that would indicate that gold should go higher, but yet it's not. Why do you think we're not seeing that yet?
Michelle, I'm confused as to what you're talking about. Ask Kitco. They'll tell you gold is up a lot in the last two years. But, you kidding me? Silver's up a lot in the last couple of years. Not in the last few months. No, everything has corrections and reactions. Don't ask me. You should ask Kitco. But if what I see is the price of gold and silver went up a lot in the last, 19 months, 20 months. They're having a correction at the moment. I hope I'm smart enough to buy more sometimes during this correction.
All right, so Jim, a lot of the flow into commodities across the board is, as we discussed, linked to expectations of inflation. But what happens if somehow it turns out that the Fed does actually know what it's doing and somehow it does manage to keep the inflation at bay and it is indeed just a transitory spike, as Powell is saying it will be? What happens in the scenario where the structural deflationary forces prevail and you actually don't get this major upswing or an overshoot in inflation? What does that mean for all of the speculative investments and money flowing into commodities?
Well, obviously you should sell your silver, you should sell your gold. If what you just said comes true, then by all means, sell it all. Sell cotton, sell copper, sell everything. Maybe that's what's going to happen. But I do also see supply and demand is changing in commodities. The supply is certainly not booming like it did a few years ago. And supply is going down. Demand seems to be going up as economies get stronger and stronger and as more and more money is printed.
So for you, it's not just inflation that's driving a potential commodity super cycle. It's based on real fundamentals of supply and demand.
Oh, no, you cannot have any bull market without supply and demand being out of balance, no matter what it is, whether it's Amazon or lead. You got to have supply and demand out of balance to have a bull market.